Hey, got a kind of strange video here for you today. Hopefully some of you might enjoy it, but I've done some customization for weapons in the past, and some people liked it and asked me to do more. I've done some customizations of some Star Wars vehicles too, some very Bob Ross-like kind of customizing and kind of chroming up of vehicles. Really, really basic stuff. Nothing like real customizers or people with major talent. I'm just botching this and doing really quick stuff. But I thought it was interesting. Again, people keep asking me to do it. So I'm going to go through and show you some weapons that I've done, some that I'm going to do. I'm going to do one live here. I'll show you just some of the paints and other stuff that you might need if you want to do this. And see what you think. In general, what I'm trying to do is get away from this kind of stuff. I absolutely hate these comic style weapons from Marvel Legends. We don't really get an issue with Star Wars weapons too much. They generally are all either black or silver. They really don't get into too much of a colorization issue. So it's really Marvel Legends with the comic stuff that they do. Does not do it for me at all. Really not a fan of the crazy colors and the crazy ass guns. They seem to think they like it, and that's up to them. But I hate it. So what I'm trying to do is get some of these weapons looking more realistic. And if anybody's going to get upset with me here, number one, I don't have a gun, don't really like guns, don't really want guns around, so I think the NRA are a bunch of asshats, but that's my personal opinion. The point is, if you have a gun, you should really have a very deeply legal reason to have one and be licensed and be sane, which would help. So that's aside, this is toy guns, and what I mean by realistic when we're talking about comics is something that looks like a gun, not really something that's like a water scooter or something, like, you know. It's just, yeah. So this was a black weapon that Hasbro made for Marvel Legends many ages ago. I can't remember who it was. Punisher or somebody had it. I can't remember. Anyway, what I did was took a little bit of, I think it was anyway, took a little bit of chrome, and you can barely see it, but I just kind of washed it and brushed it across the figure, across the weapon. Added a little standout or call-out sections of silver and a little bit of gold on there just to catch the eye. But I don't have the original, but if you get a rough idea, that's what it looked like in the past. Whoops. As I do that, whoops, not doing too good here. There we go. So it was black matte silver. You can maybe see the shine just on the other one. So just added a bit of reflection, and I'll maybe chrome this one up here, this weapon here too. So I think it can make a big difference to some of the figures, and I like it. Look, it's only for me anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So if you're going to be deeply precious and you're someone who's going to get very upset about things not being perfect, this is not the tutorial for you, so you might want to go away. But anyway, we'll have some fun. So this is the kind of effect we're going for. There's two different things I'm going to do tonight, and that is to, first of all, show you the paint that you, if you want to take, let's say, the silver weapon and turn it black. Or in the case of this is probably a better example, take this partially black, partially blue, and make it all black. And I'll show you the right kind of paint that'll generally stay on that weapon and keep it there. Again, there will be scratches, there will scuff at times. Sometimes I can make for a kind of a more weathered look, but anyway, I digress. So lots of different weapons. I'll make a botch of some of them. We're doing it live. So this is the paint which I recommend. Now, it doesn't matter. There's many variations. I'll put a link in the description below to something on Amazon and eBay, some kind of similar paint. I've chosen, in this case, carbon black. You could choose silver. You could choose any damn color you want. This is a company called Holcroft. Artistic acrylic, in this case, is basically a solid black. They've actually got a blob of paint on the outside, so you really get to see a realistic kind of reproduction of what the color would be. 80 mils, and yeah, there's shitloads of paint in here. This will last me forever. Costs like $4 or something, probably about $2 US, $3 US, so really pretty cheap. This stuff is made in Australia, but you can get it pretty much everywhere. Waterproof, important part. It's permanent, and it dries really, really quickly. So that's one thing you need. That's just one example of paint. It's an acrylic paint that is waterproof and permanent. Roughly permanent. I'll explain more as it goes on. So that's the tube. What else you will need? I've done this before in separate videos, but again, two Sharpies. In some case, in fact, the black one. Forget the black one. Silver one is the one you need. There we go. Silver Sharpie again. I'll put a link in the description below. And a gold one if you want for little touch-ups, but we'll stick with a silver one. So chroming I've discussed before, which is you take a black weapon and you basically silver a load of paint onto this and then rub the silver paint across that there. Let me very quickly do a little small weapon here. So what I'm going to do, Sharpie onto this. I'm going to paint silver, and I guess it's very hard to do while I'm doing a review here with this camera, but we'll give it a shot. And what did I do with that? As the thing dries, there we go. And I'm going to rub that on the weapon, and it'll work and it won't work, and it takes a couple of applications, and if you get too much on it, then, well, you know, don't worry about it, don't sweat it. Obviously, if you've got one figure and it's your favourite weapon, then maybe don't do it on it and practice on something that's really kind of crappy. There's plenty of cheap places you can buy some Marvel Legends figures if you want to practice on a weapon. Okay, so one pass, you can see a little bit of silver going on there. And the same goes on and on, so we just keep applying it. I'll do a little bit more and then I'll go into the black just to show you. Because again, I've got a whole separate video on the silvering up of this, which there's been many people over the years. Zach was one a guy on the YouTube channel who mentioned this, and others have mentioned, and others have done it better and done different things in paint. But anyway, you could also use silver paint here and dab it on that way as it's drying, but I find a Sharpie's really quick and easy. And again, I've only done a couple of passes there. You could try kind of like a less absorbent paper, but I tend to find kitchen roll really works well. So very quickly, you've got a little bit of a shine coming off the gun. You could then go on and add little silver touches. Again, probably a couple more passes, two or three passes, you would add a bit more metallicness to it. I've kind of botched up at this corner, but look, it doesn't matter. So that's chroming. The next thing you want to do, and you need this paper towel here just to kind of mop up the mess, is paint. Let's paint this blue weapon here. This thing here. I hate the blue. It sucks. Let's get that. I want a nice weapon to basically go with this figure here. In fact, let's do this one. This is the one I wanted to do. Not the blue. I want to get rid of this. This little purple. This is a great little weapon. I can't remember who this came with. Oh, it was Domino. Domino is who it came with. Love this little weapon. Wanted to go with my little custom Lady Deadpool here. But I hate the purple. It sucks. It doesn't go. It doesn't work. So I'm going to make it black. So paintbrush. You also need a paintbrush. I contacted Lady Fly, Mrs. Fly. She suggested these paintbrushes. She had them for nails and makeup and stuff, and she gave me this little brush here. So a little soft brush. It doesn't really matter. There's no measurements on it, but yeah, cheap or as expensive as you want. You get them in just about any craft shop. But it's little soft brushes, and because this is waterproof, you can actually quickly, once you've painted, get rid of the excess paint. So I know, it says waterproof, but you can get rid of it. But squeeze out a little paint, touch up the brush, and we are going to paint Bob Ross Stylee. Where's my little purple thing here? You're probably going to get this over your... I'm going to move this out of the way because of the focus. And you're probably going to get this over your fingers, so don't worry about it. And off you go, paint. What did Bob Ross say? Trees or something? Trees, look at the lovely trees. Anyway, get it in all the corners. And weathering something, which I'm going to get on to shortly, and if anyone's interested, I'll try and show you. Now, I have taken it from masters who've done it. Plenty of people have done far better jobs than I've done of weathering, but I'm going to give it a better shot as time goes on. And this is it. Basically, just splosh on this paint. As you can see, one side is now black. Dries really quickly, which is really nice on this paint. And it will chip. As you put this into a figure's hands again and again, you'll find it will chip. It doesn't matter so much. It almost adds a little bit of scuffing and weathering. What you're trying to do is get rid of the gargantuan amount of ridiculous purple in my mind. So a little bit of weathering here and there shouldn't solve too much of a problem. Now, I'm rushing through this and botching it, really. For time to run this, because it's already 10 minutes nearly, or 9 minutes 30. But I'm going to let it dry. It does dry really quickly after a couple of minutes. And so should you. And that'll allow you to do one side. But I'm just doing the whole thing at one pass. Very, very quickly. Just to show you. And then what you could do is, once you've got all this black paint on, is do the chromium stuff. This is actually drying already. You can actually see it a little. And it takes a few passes to get it on, get it all on there. Don't worry about your fingers. And again, don't worry about the handle part too much, because it will probably scrape in the figure's hands. And again, this customizer's out there screaming into the paint and paintbrush. No! Yeah, no. I'm just doing a quick job. So, it's actually really drying already. You can see it on this side. Thankfully, this has stayed in focus so far. There's loads of people out there. Jared, a friend of mine who paints as well, he makes a lot of custom figures. Made a custom figure of myself and Jason from the Realm Reap Gap. He does a lot of cool customs as well. Jim Hooten, a friend of mine, he does customs, normally 3.75 inches. He does great stuff with paint and stuff. So again, have some fun. That's the point of this. There we go. So, weapon is done. Now, it's kind of botched at the moment. I've rushed through it, but the purple is gone. So immediately I could almost use this weapon. There's definitely little bits of purple here and there, but we got rid of the sin, the cardinal sin of the purple paint. And again, once this is dried, you could again apply more paint if you wanted, or you could touch it up with a little bit of chrome silver or tiny little touches, the little nozzles for perhaps in there. You could add a little bit of just a little bit of gold to it. Just would look like a little cartridge or something that goes in this kind of sci-fi like gun. This thing is dry. Literally nearly dry already. So it's very, very quick acting. So that's it. I'm not going to go on too much longer, but just another look at how you can customize weapons. Again, very quickly done. You would take your time a little bit more, but that's when we get rid of that kind of stuff. And again, links to buy some of that stuff is in the description below. Hope you like to let us know what you think. Is this kind of fun or is this just sucky? Be honest. Let us know. Leave a like if you like it. And if you like the other stuff we do in the channel, click subscribe and the little bell and you'll get all those videos straight into your inbox. That's it for me. We'll see you for another figure review, another stuff like this coming up.